welcome back. And if you tuned in late today, we have two special people here, and from fresh to order. And wherever you are, you may have a fresh to order restaurant. And we have a brand new one in Greenville, South Carolina. And the gentleman who ventured into this and who obviously has had a career in the food industry is right here, Doug Sheley. And then next to him is Chef Daniel Hobbs. And he brought all these things for us to see, and he did that beautiful salad, which we have to offer you, the recipe. But we're gonna talk a little bit. This is amazing to me. You tell me that this is for one person.
Yeah, this is what we call a full entree. So
the person must have been in a desert for 2 weeks and had nothing to eat. That is at least for two people.
Well, you know, as I just said a minute ago, one of my mentors was R. David Thomas at Wendy's, and he always taught us young guys when I used to be young that he said, "Doug, people will always pay for quality if it has perceived value." And when I looked at that for the very first time as a prospective franchisee and a customer, I said, once I tasted it, I said, the quality is exceptional and the perceived value is unbelievable. Now that entree, that's a full entree. We have a three quarters.
Well, that's a full meal. Mashed sweet potatoes.
It's an Asian coleslaw. Yep, and candied walnuts on top of those as well.
And then
a little bit of cinnamon.
Is that chicken?
Yep, so these are chicken tenders that are in a satay form, which are skewered and then pressed while they're crusted, and then they're flash fried. And you get, it's basically panko, almonds, sesame seeds, a little bit of rosemary. And then we have our sauces on the bottom here is a peanut sauce and an orange glaze. The orange glaze has a little bit of spice to it. Not too bad for anybody who doesn't like spicy food, but it's got a little bit of a zing, which is nice.
And you actually create some of the recipes?
Some of them, yes. Not a lot of them. Most of those are Jesse Gideon's. Yeah. But yeah, I do. I help with a lot of the food R&D and the food development. Obviously testing new recipes and going through. But one thing about us, we're so centered on quality and freshness. One of the big things, like I mentioned before, Pierre Panos, who's the owner and founder, when he and Jesse figure out a recipe and we go through production, it doesn't hit a table in front of a guest until both of them absolutely 100% agree on everything. So it has to hit some very, very important people, obviously.
Okay, now you have like a full menu. You can have a sandwich or you can have a dinner.
We have scratch soups. We have about 6 daily to 7 daily scratch soups we make. Everything from a cream of mushroom, which is one of our biggest sellers, down to a tortilla chicken soup.
We also do a lentil soup that's vegan.
Exactly.
Okay. So you cater to people with all needs.
Yep. Absolutely.
Dietary restrictions are a big thing for us. So we have a gluten-free and a vegan menu. And pretty much anything that's on our menu, we can turn into vegan, vegetarian, you know, pull things on, like I said before, guest-centric. So anything you want when you come into the restaurant, as long as we have it and we can give it to you, absolutely, we'll give it to you.
Okay. You're what I call an American success. You didn't really plan to go into the food business.
No, I got my degree in comprehensive social studies and was going to be a teacher and was a teacher and a football coach. And then realized when I started having a family, I need to make some more money. And so, actually, I read a franchising book that I bought as a young man, and this was back in the mid-70s, and it talked about the fast food industry. And the best fast food concept that I had stumbled on at the time was Wendy's. Mm-hmm. Everything was fresh. Yeah. You know, quality is our recipe. Mr. Thomas really preached that, QSC, quality, service, and cleanliness. He made his tea that as the franchisees. And when I tasted the burger, I said, that's the best fast food burger I've ever had. Had fresh produce, tomatoes, onions. You know, and McDonald's back then was, I was convinced, which obviously I was not accurate, but I was convinced that they were probably putting fillers of some kind in their meats. so they could sell it so cheap. So I was looking for quality and nutrition back then because I'd owned two or three health clubs that I sold and then bought into Wendy's.
So you had Wendy's first.
I had Wendy's first.
And then
first.
You decided this was the way to go.
Today.
Fresh
yeah.
to order.
Yes, ma'am.
So now do people actually, they can come in and sit down and eat, or they can call ahead and order whatever and it's ready. They can come pick it up.
Is yes, that, ma'am.
So you have both options.
We're online with a call ahead or use your our website to order and to even pay for it. So all you have to do is come in and pick it up. And we have a specific register designated for those patrons when they come in. So they don't have to wait in line.
They don't have to stand in line.
No.
Okay, okay. So this is something unique, and it's brand new here in the upstate of South Carolina. Now, you have other franchises in other places?
Yes, ma'am, we do. We have, actually, the company is out of Atlanta, Georgia, and there's about 8 or 9 locations in that vicinity, along with, and they're expanding concentrically out from Atlanta and went into Nashville and Chattanooga and now are starting to franchise. Well, we went into Florida and Orlando, and they're branching out a little bit with a franchisee in Dallas, Texas, who just happens to be one of the heirs to the Johnsonville Brock family.
Okay.
And they bought 12 stores down there, and then we just, I understand they just signed a franchise agreement in Philadelphia.
Well, I have a suggestion.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't forget about the beach area of South Carolina.
Oh, no kidding. You're
what
exactly
about
right.
The Myrtle Beach area? You ought to look at that.
Well, you know, actually, I have tried to position myself where I can expand in several different directions, and that may be one of them.
I don't see how you could expand much more, but I love to see good things happen to people. And this is what America is all about. You can dream about something and work about something and make it happen. And we can't afford to lose that in this country. That's what made this country separate from all the others.
Yeah, I told my sons, I have 3 sons and 1 daughter, and 2 of my sons are Chick-fil-A operators.
Okay.
My oldest son's a Chick-fil-A operator in Rock Hill, South Carolina, and my youngest one is in Richmond, Virginia. But what I taught them and shared with them is, look, you will be rewarded equally to your effort and your energy and your desire to move forward in your career individually. And all of my sons, thank goodness, number 2 son is with a franchising company in Atlanta. Okay. So he helps his company with a software that is basically put together for the franchisors.
Okay.
Fresh to Order is looking at it.
But I think you are an inspiration to young people because you've created jobs for other people and you have something that is worthwhile. You've kept your quality.
Amen.
And you try to keep the price down because, you know, just a trip to the grocery store can blow you away because the cost of food keeps going up and up and up. And you're trying to serve quality food and still make it affordable.
Not trying. We're going to. We are actually, I've been working with Pierre and Jesse in regards to exactly what you're alluding to. And that is, we want everybody to be able to afford healthy, nutritious, and fresh food. And what we've done is our appetizers, what we've been calling appetizers, the first time I ordered one, I had the black and lime shrimp on the Asian slaw. And I ordered an entree with it because I wanted to try some.
You couldn't eat it all.
The appetizer had 8 shrimp, which we still serve today, and it filled me up. And I looked at my wife and I said, I can't even eat the entree now. So what we've done is we're taking away the word appetizer and we're putting on there small plates.
Oh, that's good.
So you can.
And I'll tell you, a lot of senior citizens too.
Exactly.
Want small plates, and that's a bonus.
And
for
I had
everybody.
A couple come in just the other
yeah.
day. As a matter of fact, I gave them a cookie each, and I said, I got to take care of my senior citizens because I'm one of them. And they said, we'll be back. But they both ordered our pork loin with sweet potatoes, whipped potatoes, as their meal, and you get about a good 4 ounce portion or 5 ounce portion of pork, and it cost them $12.
Well, if you would like the recipe that our chef Daniel did today, just send a self-addressed stamped envelope, if you can, to the Peggy Denny Show, Post Office Box 1616, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602, and the number is 856, and we'll send it to you. And this is also the brochure about the restaurant. So if you're interested, maybe you could leave me some of these as well. That's the takeout menu. So we're delighted to have had you. Thank you for sharing with us. And we want people to eat well, but we want them to be healthy.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Okay. And I hope your restaurant is smoke-free.
It is.
Okay. You just made my day. Wherever you are, we wish you joy. Yes. Bye-bye.